నమస్తే మిక్కీజీమేయర్ గారు.
నమస్తే. హాయ్.
థ్యాంక్స్ అ లాట్ ఫర్ యువర్ టైం. యాక్చువల్లీ మీరు మహానటి మూవీ చేసిన దానికి స్కోర్ చేస్తున్నారు, బ్యాక్గ్రౌండ్ స్కోర్ ఇప్పుడు సాంగ్స్ అయిపోయినాయి అనుకుంటా.
యా.
సో ఈ టైంలో మాకు టైం ఇచ్చి, ఇంటర్వ్యూకి టైం ఇచ్చినందుకు, బికాస్ ఐ హావ్ నెవర్ సీన్ మచ్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ ఇంటర్వ్యూస్.
ఓకే.
చాలా తక్కువ మాట్లాడతారు అండ్ తక్కువ ఇంటర్వ్యూస్ ఇస్తారు, ఎప్పుడు కనపడరు మీడియాలో కూడా. యు విల్ బి క్వైట్ అండ్ యు విల్ బి
No, it's my pleasure to be here with you and
thank you so much.
Been wanting to make this happen since a while, but I'm glad today we could do it.
Yeah,
on my audio launch day.
Oh, today is the audio
today
launch.
Today is the audio
oh,
launch.
Great, great. So, first of all, first and foremost, all the very best for your flick, upcoming flick Mahanati, which is very promising and everybody is, you know, eager to watch that film and eager to listen to the songs. సో మీ కంపోజింగ్ విషయానికి వస్తే, మీరేంటి, మీరు ఎక్కడి నుంచి వచ్చారు, మీ విక్కి అంతా చెప్తుంది ఆల్రెడీ, పీపుల్ నో అబౌట్ యూ. సో సో అందుకని టెక్నికల్ పార్ట్ మాట్లాడుకుందాము. సో మీరు యాక్చువల్లీ హ్యాపీ డేస్ మూవీ వాజ్ అ సో ఇట్ వాజ్ అ బిగ్ హిట్ ఇన్ తెలుగు, కన్నడ అండ్ తమిళ్. యా, కన్నడ అండ్ తమిళ్ వర్ రీమేక్స్, రైట్? సో మీరు దానికి సేమ్ సాంగ్స్ ఇచ్చారా కన్నడ?
యా, ఇట్ వాస్ ద సేమ్ సాంగ్, జస్ట్ ఎ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఆఫ్ చేంజెస్ ఇన్ ద తమిళ్ ఆల్బమ్.
తమిళ్? ఓకే. ఎనీ నేటివిటీ బేస్డ్?
నో, నథింగ్ లైక్ దట్. ఇట్ వాస్ జస్ట్
సేమ్
థింగ్, బట్ జస్ట్ ఎ లిటిల్ ద చేంజ్ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఇన్ ద స్క్రిప్ట్ అండ్ ఆల్సో.
హిట్ ఎలా ఉండింది, డిఫరెన్షియేట్ చేస్తే త్రీ లాంగ్వేజెస్ లో అండ్ హౌ
ద హ్యాపీ డేస్ వాస్ బిగ్?
ఇట్
వాస్ అ టర్నింగ్ పాయింట్ ఇన్ మై కెరియర్. Not only for me, a lot of other people as well. So the director got a great name with that movie, and a lot of other actors also got established with that. That movie is like, you know, it's in every, you know, composer's life there is one movie that changes their career. So for me, Happy Days was like that, and that opened up a lot of doors for me, and so there was no looking back from there.
True. And after that, Kotta Bangaru Lokam.
Yeah.
A song, ippudki, it's an evergreen song asalu. Kotta Bangaru Lokam title song.
Yeah.
Everyone loves it and shuffle chese playlist lo untundi and repeat song. And we loved it. And me style lo, meeku, do you love Indian Carnatic or any classical stuff?
So I grew up learning Western classical. I never learned Hindustani or Carnatic.
But you bring at least the
style. Yeah, I don't know. It's just I just kind of, you know, I've not learned these Hindustani and Carnatic, but somehow I get that. I feel I don't have to learn any kind of art to be able to do it. It's just you get a feel for it, you know, like,
yeah.
And then you just make it and your tunes come, you know, in some style of Karnataka, or like recently Sada Nannu that we released, it's more Karnataka based, but I have not learned Karnataka, but you know, just
but you bring the style essence ekkada oka chota essence adi kanapadtundi.
Yeah, it just happens. I mean,
yeah, it reveals that you love, you have a certain place
yeah, definitely I like Hindustani and Karnataka, and to be able to do it in movies is actually also very good, because a lot of times you don't get opportunities to, you know, work on like some ragas and stuff like that. So but in movies you have that opportunity to mix it with modern,
yes,
stuff and all. So it always gives it's a good feeling to have you know, different, you know, Western classical, Carnatic and Hindustani, and so many other, you know, styles of music.
Proper blend, actually it's very difficult to combine both, and or else bring the essence of classical music into Western based songs is very tough job actually. But
yeah,
you but meer entante anni paatlo just ala blend untundi, just casual blend laga chala bond anamata songs.
Yeah, it's just you know, I value lyrics a lot in all my songs, so when something is shaping up, you know, even the lyrics help actually. So a lot of times if there's a specific tune, the way lyrics are written also helps the tune. So it's all a good combination of composition, lyrics and singer's voice, and you know, the whole orchestration of the song. There's so many things that go into a hit song. Not only just my work, but others' work also adds to the song.
But picking of singers also, from Hyderabad you pick a lot of singers and you gave opportunities to them. So how did you find the singers in Hyderabad?
No, there's a lot of talent here. In Mahanati, like a lot of people have sung. Anurag, Ramya, yeah, and Sunita has sung one song. It's always good to work with the local talent. And I'm from Hyderabad, and I always like to encourage people from my own city. It's always good to have, a mix of all talents from everywhere. I always want to encourage people from here, from Hyderabad and from Andhra Pradesh and Telangana.
That's a great thing. Actually, are you from Hyderabad?
Yeah, I'm from Hyderabad. Born and brought up.
Raised in Hyderabad?
Yeah. I did my school in St. Mark's and my college was St. Mary's in Secunderabad.
Okay.
I grew up in Hyderabad only, and I'm a pakka Hyderabadi. Lot of people think some people think I'm from Kerala, or some people think I'm from America. I'm from Hyderabad only. Now I'm living in America. But I'm born and bred. I just moved a year back. I've been shuffling there. I've been spending time there. But now I've permanently moved there.
Okay.
I'm living there with my family.
You married?
Yeah. I got married in 2010. Yeah, my wife is an American. And I have a daughter. She's 6 years old.
Oh, wow.
My son is 3.
Oh.
That's
a nice thing.
Yeah.
So you will compose songs from there.
I have my studio in America.
Yeah. So as long as technology is there, it's not a big deal.
When I compose here, I don't even meet my director and producers.
Cool. They trust you.
First I meet them for the story sitting, mm-hmm. and then I meet them probably on audio launch day or.
Wow.
So I'm here or there, it doesn't matter to them.
It reveals all they want that they trust on you. Actually.
Yeah, they totally trust me, and I'm really thankful for that. And I'm able to, live in both the worlds, like in America and in India, and still be able to do my job. So it's a great blessing.
Great.
And I'm looking forward to this year with a lot of projects and work.
Yeah. Tell us about the latest flicks, actually, that you
Mahanati.
Composed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Mahanati is, I think,
upcoming. Audio is out.
Yeah, today they're going to launch. Mm-hmm. They only released 2 songs.
Mm-hmm.
Today they are going to
only 2 songs in the flick?
No. There are 6 songs.
Okay.
But online they just released 2 songs. Okay. And now today they are releasing the whole album, Jukebox, that is.
Okay.
It's Mahanati is like a milestone in my career. It's like really it's a movie that I would always, maybe I would want to be a part of, and I'm glad that I got such a movie.
Great team, I guess.
Very great team. Lot of talented people working in this movie. Lot of talented actors, technicians. So you can see all that work that comes in when the movie releases. You'll definitely see like a wide span of talents going in that. So it's a great movie, and the way Ashwin has directed it,
yes.
I think he's matured very much as a it's just his second movie.
Yeah, but Evaday Subramanyam created.
Yeah, so he's like he's matured as a director, and I'm kind of wondering what he will make next, because this is like so big, he's a perfectionist,
Actually, when I was traveling to the USA, some women team found me, and they gave me the hard disk of Evaday Subramanyam to carry to the Seattle.
Oh, is it? Okay.
So I carried the hard disk for the release.
Oh, okay. Hopefully this time everything will be in time and not the end moment, which usually happens in our film industry. So I'm looking forward to the release of this movie and the audio launch. And so I think I'm hoping that it'll be a big hit.
Definitely, it's going to be a big hit, and all the very best to you.
Thank you. Yeah.
And how do you find when people picks up the panic talk or divide talk for the films? How do you feel?
Sometimes once we work on a movie and once it releases, that's it. Our work is done. So we can't do anything about if people liked it or not, or if it's a hit, it's good for us. If it is not, then we can't do anything about it. It's a flop is whatever you think is not going to change the fate of the movie.
Yes.
If it's a hit, it's going to be a hit. If it's flop, you can't make it a hit, or whatever you say online media or whatever, wherever it is. People like it, they like it. If they don't, they don't. So I don't really think about all that, if it doesn't do well, it kind of hits us for a few days. I mean,
there will be so many reasons for
There's, you know,
flop.
The maybe script is not good, or the
it's a teamwork,
the editing was not great, or whatever, music was not good. So there's so many things that go into it. But if it's a hit, it's good for us.
But
it's, you know, it's a part of our work, you know.
Because
sometimes they do good, sometimes they don't.
Yeah, unless the movie is hit, people, they won't listen to the songs. They will just ignore the songs.
Sometimes I feel if the album is really good, then it, you know, it has a good number of listening on YouTube. But if the movie is a hit, definitely, yeah. It's because the word spreads, you know. Everyone wants to watch the movie, and then the hype is created even more. So people talk about the movie. So that's how even the songs are talked about. And so the ultimate thing is, the success of a movie is, in nowadays, it's become like the, you know, the crucial part of success, you know. And the success of the movie talks more than anything else.
Are you doing any projects to go international, this thing?
I have certain plans. It'll take a long time though, but it's, you know, I don't know when it'll happen, but I've started that initiative to, since I am now living in America, I've started the initiative to do something as an independent artist too.
Unlike us, they won't have any songs in their clicks and independent.
It's all different there. It's the whole film industry is different there, and here the songs work for us, there the background score works for them. So it's just a different way of making movies there.
If at all they have, they'll have one song.
Yeah, but it's not song oriented movies anyways, yes, there. So it's more of a background score, which is very challenging as well, because it's really tough to create those background scores with, like, you know, 100 team orchestra, and so it's at a different, totally different way of working there.
So you want to go compose?
Yeah, you know, if there is
at all chance given.
Yeah, I like to take things slowly, and I kind of set a timeline for thing. If in the next 10 years, if I get into Hollywood, then I'm happy. I know that it's not going to happen in 1 month or 1 year or 2 years. It's a long, long, you know, struggle for that. So parallelly, I'm going to try and, you know, do that. So that's going on in the back.
Great. Actually, you composed for Mahesh Babu's flicks. Sitamava Kitlo was a big hit.
Yeah.
Chala pedda hit ayindi. And then Brahmotsavam manam ippudu maatladukunnattu
movie wasn't
unless and until the flick is a hit. So ఇప్పుడు ఒకటి బ్రహ్మోత్సవంలో మీరు ఒక పాట పిక్ చేసుకున్నారు, దాంట్లో ఒక రిధమ్ పిక్ చేసుకున్నందుకు పీపుల్ దే స్పోక్ అలాట్, ఈ అది ఇది ఇది అది అన్నారు. అప్పుడు ఎలా ఫీల్ అయ్యారు? యాక్చువల్లీ ఏ ఒక్క చేసినా కూడా దానికి కాపీ క్యాట్ అనేసి ట్యాగ్ చేస్తారు, బట్ అదర్వైజ్ మనం చేసిన కంపోజ్ చేసిన బంచ్ ఆఫ్ సాంగ్స్ గురించి
ఆలోచించ people who write negative.
Yeah.
So if you see like a movie like Bahubali, in 1 million viewers, there will be one person who will say this is the worst movie ever made. You know, so there are those kind of people which exist. So it's everyone's, you know, freedom of speech. They write whatever they want.
It's just rhythm, right?
But for me, in that song, firstly, I didn't copy anything. The guitar, you know, people are out there searching for music that sounds similar, or, you know, even vaguely similar. If it sounds, they post something, you know, it's copied from there. So that song, the guitar that I used, it's just the same guitar progression was in that other song. And I should say it's another guitar and it's another sounding and everything, but it
the
kind
title
of just gives the same guitar progression. And that song, you don't even hear Vachindi Kada Avakasham in that song. So how is it a copy? I couldn't even understand. So all through my career, you know, that was the first time someone wrote that. So that's why I had to reply back, because why should I keep quiet when I've just online I had, you know, written on Facebook.
Write a pitch,
So when there's something which is wrong, I feel I should write it, you know. If I would really had copied it, I would have kept quiet probably. I wouldn't have said anything. But if something is not true and if I keep quiet, then people think, okay, maybe he copied it, you know.
Hmm.
So that's why I had to write that, you know, I had to explain that whole situation.
Yeah.
And that was the only time that someone, you know, people had pointed out.
Anybody but asked again, you to, for the similar composition?
No,
or
no,
just like
I,
that
I never listened to any director or producers. Advice of copying. If anyone tells me to copy, I'm never. No one even asks me actually. No one even tells me any song reference, or no one even advises me, oh sir, there is one song, we'll try to mix that, nothing, you know. It's all original stuff that I do.
You can so, go, you can be like happy go lucky then.
Yeah, yeah. I would never copy anyone else's work, and even if I get a greatest movie in the earth and they ask me to copy, I will leave that movie, but I will never copy because that's against my principles, you know. Mm-hmm. That's cheating. That's
so people will come to know now.
Yeah,
with a better
but
way.
It doesn't matter, you know.
Yeah.
People can write whatever they like. I know in my heart that I've not copied, that only one time I replied, but I know that in the future whatever they write, I'm not probably going to.
Yes.
You know, that was the first time. So first time, because right from my first movie, I made it clear that I will not copy a song. And in the initial stages, there were some movie offers where they wanted some remix or all that. So I had said no to those projects because
okay. You composed
I don't want to copy other songs. Composers' work.
Okay.
Why should I, when I can create great songs, why
for
should I copy?
Remix also.
Yeah, yeah, anything. So this was first time that, you know, and it's a big project, Brahmotsam.
Yes.
And so I was kind of shaken first time.
Mm-hmm.
Then I decided, okay, this is the first time, okay, I should just reply back. And but in the future, I don't care now, you know.
Yeah.
They can, some people can write whatever they like.
You know how to take it now.
Yeah, I'll just leave it, you know, just because people know my talent now, and you know, they
definitely
know my strength.
There
as
are
a
bunch
composer.
Of already there are bunch of songs, those are big hits.
Yeah. So it's just it's a way of, you know, how things work in the industry, you know. So it's fine, you know.
So Mahanati audio lo songs gurinchi cheppandi. Ee genre lo untayi?
Yeah, Mahanati audio, it's a very, you know, the movie goes back to 1950s and 60s, you know, Savitri garu's you know, time of when she made movies and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And also her last part of life in the 80s, you know. So
interesting.
Very, I mean, it's a whole, it's a very genuine biopic of her.
Okay.
And you see a lot of her, you know, life in the movie, her ups, downs, you know, from where she came, you know, as a child, and you know, how big she became. She was like a superstar.
Yeah.
And her success, and you know, then her downfall, and everything is shown in this movie.
Last
so it's a very it's like a rough boat ride, you know. It goes through calm waters, then goes in the seas, the oceans, you know, rough waves, and then so it's a whole storm, like, you know,
such
in the movie.
A subject.
So it's like, I think it's one of the best movies that I could ever work on, in terms of how much I could use my talent in giving the best for the movie. So the songs also had to match that whole era of, you know, her film era. So there's like, you know, the songs, like there's 5-6 songs in the album. So the first song is a childhood song where, you know, you show her as a small kid. So Ramya Behara has sung that song.
Child artist.
She's you show her childhood. So the singing has been done by Ramya. And then there's another song, Mooga Manasulu, which is sung by Shreya Ghoshal and Anurag Kulkarni. That's also a very romantic track between her and Jemini Ganeshan. then there's Sada Nannu, which is also a romantic track between them both, and it's sung by Charulata Mani. She's also a very good artist, you know, she's Karnataka based, and yeah, but she also has a great understanding of commercial in, I mean, film.
Mm-hmm.
Music. So
from which part of the
she is in Australia now. I think she's from Chennai.
Mm-hmm.
But living in Australia now. So I wanted some voice which is really, you know, that soulfulness is there, and at the same time they're not 100% Karnataka, but they also understand cinema,
to
music.
Modulate the requirement.
Yeah, so she did a great job. and there's Mahanati title song, which is sung by Anurag again.
Anurag Kulkarni.
And he's done really great. I mean, his range
Hindustani
of
Hindustani student.
Sorry?
Hindustani. He learned Hindustani, I guess.
I don't know. But he's really good.
Recently, I came to know about him.
Oh, is it? Okay. Mm. And then there is Chivaraku Migledi, that is it's like a climax song of the movie, which is sung by Sunita Garu. So even in the Tamil version, it's going to release in Tamil as well. So Nayana is another singer who has sung Mooga Manasulu and the childhood song
in Tamil?
Also Chivaraku Migledi, yeah.
Okay.
In Tamil.
At the same time?
Yeah, it's going to release simultaneously in Tamil and Telugu. So it was fun working on this album, and it took us quite some time. I started in 2000.
You'll be entering into Tamil field, or already you have done Happy Days in Tamil?
Yeah, but I'm kind of focused here in Telugu only. So if there are some great opportunities there, I don't mind.
Yeah, Tamil industry is always the music lovers.
Yeah.
They welcome new talents and all.
That's
so.
True. Yeah. Yes. But I think I'm content and happy in Telugu. So I'm not too keen in Tamil or Kannada or Malayalam or any other thing.
Okay.
I like to balance my life, you know. It's like I have a family and I know so many friends back in America and all. So I don't want to be working so much that I lose all that precious, you know, time with my kids and my mom, my wife. So I want to probably take one project at a time, do it and just take off, you know, and I don't want to be busy so much, you know, it's because your life is only once, you know, and if you just spend all your life working, then what's the point of living, you know?
True.
So I'm just taking it very slow. I've always taken my career very slowly.
Okay.
And I'm so happy because I've seen so much and I've spent so much time with friends and, you know, never no stress on mine. And if I do like 5-10 projects a year, you are like every day you have to make a tune.
Yes.
And you're just stressed about it and then the release dates, and I think I want to take it really slow. And
how do you manage taking up the projects actually whenever you get so many?
Well, it's more like there are a few producers who love my music. And it's almost like I am booked for 10 years. It's like that.
That's a great thing.
So, once I am doing something, like say with Dilraju sir, and once it is ready to finish, there's another one he gives me. And so, they are like these producers and directors who love my music. And they are always ready with something. So, I mean, it's like, you know, I'm blessed to be in a situation as me, because there's no stress, as in even if I do one movie a year, it's not like, so other day I was in a conference and someone asked me, so don't have much offers and all. I'm like, it's, you know, I don't want much offers anyways, you know, I don't want 10, 15 or 8 movies a year. I don't look forward to that. So the lesser the work, I'm happy. Because, you know, I'm charging whatever remuneration I charge. I'm happy with that. And I'm stressing more on quality work. That has been my agenda since I started here in Tollywood. I want to be known as a great composer over the years. You know, I don't want to... My songs, I want them to be heard whenever, you know, even after 15 years, I want my song to be able to be heard.
They are. Actually, if we go to Kottabangar Lokam or Happy Days,
yeah.
The first
so
movie,
your
first
movie Pote
was Pote Pone, and then
Pote Pone, 10th class,
then Notebook. 10th class songs are also,
tenth class,
you know,
good.
So many Hyderabad singers sang.
Yeah.
KC, Krishna Chaitanya,
Deepu was there.
They mention in their interviews about the songs and.
Yeah. So it's like, you know, a few years back, you know, I sometimes go online and, you know, keep checking about, because it's good to also know what people are writing about you and what's happening. And someone wrote, why is MickeyJMeyer out of Tollywood? So people write all kind of things, you know. They feel if I do 8 movies a year, then I'm successful and I'm busy and all that.
You're keen on quality, not on quantity.
I'm keen on quality, and for someone else, what busy is, for me, busy is different. For me, doing one movie a year is busy. I'm busy doing my work. In a year, I'm doing a movie. If I'm doing a movie, I feel I'm busy, you know. You don't have to do 10 movies to be busy. It's how you treat your work and how you think about your work. I spend, you know, 2 months on one song. So I'm busy spending 2 months on one song. Some people spend one day on one song. So it's just the perspective is different, you know. So there was never that I was with no offers, and, you know, I've always had more than I wanted. So it's just I distance myself away from some projects because I don't want to be so immersed in that, because music is not all my life, you know. Music is a small part of my life. There's other things also in life which are important. So I consider all other things also as a part, important part of my life. So that was, I'm blessed that, you know, I have good producers and directors who come with good scripts, and, you know, they keep coming back to me. And, you know, if you don't make something successful, no one wants you in the industry, you know. It's unless until my music is not great, I wouldn't be sustaining so long.
Definitely.
So I know that I know my strengths, and I know my how much fame I have, and, you know, how many fans, you know, like people like my music. I know all that in the back of my mind, but I'm a very simple person, and I don't like to start thinking like I am a celebrity, or, you know, oh, people know my music, or, you know,
we can see that, you know.
So it's always good to be just grounded, and I know that even for next 50 years I will be making music in Tollywood, whatever people might write, no offers or not busy or whatever, but I know that my music is so strong,
yeah,
that it will sustain me till whenever I want to make music, you know.
Your mark is there, prati chota undi, is everywhere, ante marriage videos lo kuda mee song vestaru.
Yeah, I know. It's, you know, that's my purpose of, you know, I want to make music that is useful, you know, that you can listen to and probably use it for some of your videos.
Prati wedding video lo kuda ippudu mee song undi.
That's what I mean.
Sitamma market lo adi oka anni landmarks laga time to time idi oka song velthu untundi.
Yeah, I mean it's good. I'm happy the way things are going.
Yeah, mee wife ela enjoy chestaru Indian music, the mee compositions and any suggestions?
She doesn't listen to my music
really
at all. No. she doesn't even know much of my work and all. So she is just
what
my
is she actually?
She was a teacher,
mm-hmm,
but after we got married, she moved here to India,
mm-hmm,
and she was living here with me in India. So she's not too musically inclined,
mm-hmm,
and she doesn't even keep a track of what I am doing, as in what
okay
movies next.
It's your world completely.
Yeah.
Okay.
So when I am with my family, I don't even talk about my music, and don't even.
But when you go out in India, you know, people come to you, they recognize you, they'll talk to you.
Yeah. I mean, my wife knows that I am, you know, a good composer here and all, but it's just that she's not crazily, you know, she doesn't keep a track of, she's not my fan.
Okay.
It's like that. She's not my musical fan.
Maybe she's not expressing that out.
Maybe she's just casual about it. Okay. Nice. She's always wanted to go to one audio launch with me. So maybe, I don't know, some audio launch I will take
in near future.
Yeah.
How about your kids?
My daughter, she listens to a lot of my songs.
Nice.
So she has a good talent of music.
Mm-hmm. It's gene based. She'll be into music.
She is good. I mean, she already composes rhythm with her mouth and, you know, and all
nice
that.
So mouth percussion.
So I think I can see her going musically inclined towards music.
You have done course in Trinity
College
of UK.
London. Learned
so
piano.
Any plans
and
for
violin.
Her, your daughter?
She's just young, I think. She's only 6 years old. So maybe after a few
at
years.
At the age of six, she's making some mouth percussions.
Great. She's good. I mean, I just want to leave her to a few more years.
Okay.
She will find out for herself what.
And what's your favorite?
Usually I listen to a lot of bands like Coldplay and there's some international bands that I listen to.
soft
and
rock.
Lot of yeah soft rock rocks. Rock and you know
guitar based
yeah so it's I keep listening to different whatever is popular okay. I listen
whatever
I
is new
select genre like that yeah
okay like ante mi playlist lo ela untai
no I don't keep any playlist
no.
No,
okay.
No I just I have albums which I just listen anytime
okay ఎనీ తెలుగు స్టఫ్ ఉంటుందా దాంట్లో
ఓన్లీ మై ఆల్బమ్స్
యూఆర్ సో సెల్ఫిష్
ఐ ఎంజాయ్ లిస్నింగ్ టు మై సాంగ్స్
దట్స్ రియల్లీ గ్రేట్ మీరు ఫుడీనా
ఫుడీ మీన్స్ నో ఐ యామ్ నాట్ ఎ ఫుడీ యా ఐ కుక్ ఐ కెన్ కుక్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ డిషెస్ ఐ కెన్ కుక్
ఏం క్విజిన్
నో ఐ కెన్ కుక్ ఇండియన్ ఓన్లీ like rice and dal and you know some curries and roti and all that
okay
because when I travel I like to cook and eat
okay okay so but ikkada question appudu meeru
no I don't cook here okay. My mom cooks or you know we have a cook who also does that
okay mee amma gar ikkada untara
yeah yeah she lives with me here and when I go to America she's there with me
nice
she moves with me whenever okay. I go yeah
but ekku enduku bayitiki raru ఎక్కువ అంటే అందరు మ్యూజిక్ డైరెక్టర్స్ వచ్చినట్టు మీరు ఎక్కడ కనిపించరు యాక్చువల్లీ మా మేము మాకు ఇంటర్వ్యూ వచ్చిందంటే విఆర్ ఫీలింగ్ సో గ్రేట్ బట్ ఐ సా యూ ఎట్ అన్ అవార్డ్ ఫంక్షన్ బిగ్ ఎఫ్ఎం అవార్డ్
ఓకే ఓకే
మిమ్మల్ని చూసాను అవార్డ్ వచ్చినట్టు
ఐ డోంట్ నో మేబీ ఐ జస్ట్ లైక్ టు బి ఎ లిటిల్ ప్రైవేట్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ I enjoy my own time, you know, when I make music and everything, so...
More time into music.
Yeah, whenever I can, you know, like giving interviews and all, I feel it's good, but I somehow want to do it whenever, you know, not like so much of it, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, my awards guru in Japan, the career lock, sir, when I came there, from the first flick to, till the day.
Awards, I've got like two Filmfare awards and I think three Nandi awards.
Great.
So
Nandi awards for which?
For Happy Days, Kotta Bangara Lokam, and I think recently for movie. So awards are nothing, not mean much to me. I mean, they are good when they come. They're good. They are good. But it's a good recognition.
My son loves that song from some folkish folk touch
okay song. yeah
song chaala ishtam dantlo rhythm chaala
yeah
ee flick vachina okati manchi pick up untundi meedi oka song kids ko oka song
yeah.
melody ko oka song
yeah
so you got two film fair awards
yeah two film fair awards
and then we hope you get more awards for Mahanti
no which hope so
yeah
yeah
nice talking to you Andy thank okay. you and all the very best for upcoming flick and we wish meeku chaala manchi manchi inga projects raavali already chepparu they are in queue and cheppesi so all the best and
thank
all the
you.
Very best thank you so much for
thank you.
Giving
my pleasure
yeah inta inta ante inta workload lo undi kuda time ichinanduku chaala thanks Andy
thank you
సో ఇది ఈరోజు మిక్కీ జే మేయర్ గారితో చాలా విషయాలు మాట్లాడుకున్నాం సో నెక్స్ట్ ఎపిసోడ్లో ఇంకొక మ్యూజిక్ సెలబ్రిటీతో వచ్చేద్దాం అంటిల్ దెన్ మీ కౌసల్య ఇన్ మ్యూజికల్ కౌంటర్స్ విత్ కౌసల్య ఫర్ TVNXT సైనింగ్ ఆఫ్
హాయ్ దిస్ ఇస్ మిక్కీ జే మేయర్ లైక్ అండ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ TVNXT
వీడియోస్ కనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ షేర్ అండ్ డోంట్ ఫర్గెట్ టు సబ్స్క్రైబ్